In this video, you learn about discovering, prioritizing, and mitigating the Log4j exploit by using Microsoft Defender for Endpoint. Log4j is a widely used Java-based logging library. Many open-source libraries include it, and major software applications embed it. Because it's a cross-platform library, attackers can exploit the Log4j vulnerability on many platforms, including Windows and Linux, exposing them to remote code execution that could lead to full attacker control. That's the bad news. The good news is that Microsoft security teams have introduced new capabilities in threat and vulnerability management that help you to discover exposed devices, prioritize your effort, and mitigate the vulnerability, all in one place. I'll start on the Threat and Vulnerability Management dashboard, where you see the Threat Awareness card. It offers quick visibility into how exposed your organization is to a vulnerability. It indicates how many onboarded devices, discovered but not onboarded devices, files, and software are vulnerable to the threat. On the Threat Awareness card, select View Vulnerability Details to drill down into it. Then, on the Vulnerability page, you see a summary of the vulnerability in the sidebar that includes the CVE name and severity. The right side of the page shows a summary of the values you saw on the Threat Awareness card, plus top security recommendations. The Threat Awareness card on the previous page and the details you see on this page are a brand new experience that we built for Log4j, but we're expanding it to all vulnerabilities. Beyond the overview, the Exposed Devices Onboarded tab shows a list of exposed devices that are onboarded to Defender for Endpoint. For each device, you see its name, operating system platform, date last seen, vulnerable software and files, and, importantly, its mitigation status. Notice the Mitigation Options button. I'll come back to that later. Select any device in the list to see more information about it, like logged on users and device details. On the Exposed Devices Not Onboarded tab, you find a list of exposed devices that we've discovered, but you haven't yet onboarded to Defender for Endpoint, for whatever reason. This list shows the IP address, name, operating system platform, and date last seen for each. The source of this information is our standard device discovery capabilities. The next tab is Vulnerable Files, which lists the files that are vulnerable to the exploit. It helps you to prioritize by telling you how many devices have a process that use the vulnerable file. Plus, it shows you how many of those devices also listen to network traffic. So if you have 3,000 devices that contain vulnerable files, but only 100 are using it, you can reasonably prioritize the 100 first and come back to the rest later. You can expand a file to see the path to the vulnerable file in archives, and select the file to see more details about it. That includes a list of devices containing the file, when we last saw the file on each device, and more importantly, when we last saw a running process using the file, and when we last saw a running process using the file with an open port. You can export this list to share it with the IT team to help mitigate these devices, like you can do on any of the other lists. The next tab, Vulnerable Software, lists the applications vulnerable to the exploit. For each, the list shows typical threat and vulnerability management information, like the software name, vendor, types of threats found, exposed devices over time, and impact. The last tab is Security Recommendations, and it lists our recommendations directly related to this vulnerability. Like the previous tab, it shows for each recommendation the related components, types of threats found, exposed devices over time, and more. There are two ways to mitigate this vulnerability in the Log4j library. Update the library, which could break critical apps, or apply a mitigation workaround that buys you some time to apply security updates. The temporary solution sets an environment variable on targeted devices that helps to prevent the exploit. To apply the mitigation, select Mitigation Options. I mentioned this button earlier, and it appears on all the tabs I've shown. Then, choose whether to apply the mitigation to all exposed devices or to specific exposed devices in your organization. Last, select Create Mitigation Action to apply the action to all selected devices. When you're ready, select Proceed. The action can take up to 12 hours to complete, and you can monitor its progress in the Mitigation Status column on the Exposed Devices Onboarded tab. The last thing I want to mention here is that you can get access to the same vulnerability page from the recommendations page. It shows a similar threat awareness card at the top of the page. The new vulnerability page for the Log4j exploit helps you to better discover the scope of your exposure, prioritize your effort, and effectively mitigate it. For more information about threat and vulnerability management, we encourage you to see our documentation on Microsoft Docs. Microsoft Security.